Ready to stop worrying and tap into your power? Then join me on today's show. Last week on the show, I was helping you get better, and one thing that human beings could do to get better at the life they're living is, when you're facing a particularly challenging circumstance, don't waste any time remembering how badly things like this have gone in the past. Put all of your attention into remembering and recalling how you've succeeded previously in circumstances such as this. It's not really as if less outwardly anxious people are braver or know something that you don't, it's just that whenever they find themselves in a particularly challenging circumstance, they tend to remember times when they've actually achieved or accomplished the difficult things that they're facing. They don't remember how painful it was. They don't put all of their time and attention into recalling how miserable it made them failing. Your average burglar or looter isn't spending very much time thinking about all the terrible things that could come as a consequence of them acting so immorally and unpleasantly towards the rest of society. Flip no. They're really focused on all the gold and jewels that they're going to get for their efforts. Our prison system is literally full of people with very little impulse control, who have a hard time playing their events forward to see how it's going to go badly for them. Well, just exactly how do I benefit from knowing that, you wonder? Well, if optimism increases your life expectancy and pessimism shortens it, I think we can agree that you're at your most powerful when you're at your most optimistic. It's going to go well. You're not going to get caught for burglary. Actually, don't burgle, that's just wrong. We've covered that's unethical. I just want you to stop robbing yourself of wonderful experiences by convincing yourself that you have to hide from life. And so to help you come out of hiding and have the most fulfilling life possible for you without committing crimes, I'd like to invite you to join me on this next meditation. Now, only if it's safe and appropriate for you to close your eyes and pretend that life isn't continuing to go on outside of your head, do I suggest that you follow along. If it's not safe and appropriate for you right now, then come back later and do this later, okay? But if it is, really is, definitely is okay, then here we go. Allow yourself to sit back in your chair. Place your feet firmly on the floor so you can feel how grounded you are. And getting comfortable with your back up against the backrest, simply close your eyes and take a deep inhale. And slowly, slowly, slowly allow that air to leave your body more rested, calm, and comfortable than before. Tell yourself that it's okay to just rest and be for a few moments, and use that voice inside your mind to assure yourself that everything will be okay. And then simply focus on becoming more and more relaxed and at ease with each and every slow exhale. And simply let go of needing to know anything and focus on what you feel makes sense. And it makes sense to bring your mind back to calmness and clarity should it drift into some thought or other. And so as you softly hold your mind from drifting anywhere dangerous for you to ponder, you could consider, what are the safest memories I can find now to feel strong about? What memories of confidence and feeling powerful exist within you, and exist within the life you've had, that form the memories that you've made over the course of your time here on Earth? And what on earth were you thinking to let your mind drift somewhere dangerously before you knew better? But now, as you breathe in this realization that you are the accumulation of everything that you've ever experienced, you can begin to amass powerful memories of experiences that have been powerful for you. And so as you just drift and breathe, I wonder what powerful memories tap on your mind for you to tap into and make the most of, and the most from you and your life going forwards. And so maybe there's a decision that you can make right now about how you do things differently going forwards. And if it feels right to you right now to make that decision for you right now in this moment, and let that settle and really become a part of you, then I can invite you to slowly and gently bring yourself back to the body that you left sitting in that chair, to feel more fully integrated into you and using your breath to circulate that energy in your body, to bring you like a crescendo out of this lull and into the waking reality that you share with your eyes open every day. And as you realize what a wonderful memory this is to tap into, I'll leave you looking forward to next week's show, when you and I are going to kick bad habits together. But if you have a bad habit of missing the show, I can't help you with that. I can only suggest you share, subscribe, like the show, and make more out of these resources for you and all your family. You never know, they could really thank you for it. See you next week. Stay confident.